Ray Kurzweil, The Technological Singularity and the Future of Humanity. Year 2047, a new beginning or the beginning of the end for humanity. Artificial neural networks, adaptive algorithms, machine learning, artificial intelligence. These are all terms we often hear about without understanding their true meaning, unless we are familiar with the rapid progress already achieved in the field of computing. Today we have robots that can print portraits, compose music, and write articles for newspapers. Robots that buy and sell securities on the stock exchange. And that for a long time they surpass human intelligence in the most complex mental game, chess. 40 years ago we had Pong. Do you remember? Two rectangles and a point on the screen. Now we have photorealistic 3D simulations with millions of people simultaneously playing video games of incredible complexity. In another 40 years, what will we have? When people can't tell the difference between artificial and human intelligence, will humans become obsolete, like the floppy disk? Or will it be a world where artificial and human intelligence merge to usher in the next step of our evolution? That's the technological singularity, the theoretical time in the future where technological development will outpace our abilities to maintain control over it. For better or worse, it's undoubtedly something that will result in never-seen changes to our world. This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community. They have thousands of classes covering all different types of skills, and especially creative skills. And they have a premium membership, and this gives you unlimited access to all of the classes. For example, film and video, photography, fine art, and many others. So you can join in and learn all about the skills that you want. It's a great place to fuel your curiosity and your creativity because you can look up any kind of class that you might be curious about or a skill that you want to tackle. A class that I've found really useful for me is Productivity for Creatives by Thomas Frank. It helped me a lot to boost my productivity, so if you're interested to improve your daily productivity, this class will really help you. Because Skillshare is sponsoring this video, the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare, so you can start exploring your creativity today. By 2029, computers will reach human-level intelligence. It's not just any guy who says so, but the famous Ray Kurzweil, chief engineer at Google and guru in the world of computing. It's not the first time that the controversial scientist plays the role of the oracle. The same Ray Kurzweil is so fond of his predictions to keep track of their accuracy. At the moment, well, 86% of his 147 prophecies have been proven correct, 12% only partially correct, and 2% wrong. In about 8 years, however, we will know if the most ambitious of his hypotheses have proved to be correct. And really, artificial intelligence will be able to reason, think in abstract terms, understand complex ideas, and all the other skills that characterize humans. Also according to Kurzweil, however, there is another date to mark on the calendar, 2047, the year in which, according to him, will become reality the so-called technological singularity, or the time when technological progress will reach a speed that will radically change the world as we know it, and in which the intelligence of machines will exceed several measures that of man. But exactly what is a singularity, and more importantly, how does it manifest itself? History is replete with instances where a revolutionary new technology, or a collection of such technologies, completely changes people's lives. The change is often so dramatic that people who lived before the technological leap have difficulty understanding how subsequent generations think. For people before the change, the new generation may even be alien in their way of thinking and seeing the world. To make the point, predictive analysts often compare modern smartphone technology to Apollo-era computers, and remind us that NASA computers had the equivalent of 73,728 bytes of memory, while smartphones have up to 32 gigabytes of memory, about 430,000 times the working memory of the Apollo guidance computer. Not to mention that the computers on Voyager 1 and 2, the spacecraft that explored the outer planets and became the first man-made objects to reach interstellar space, run on 69.63 kilobytes of memory each. These dramatic and sudden changes, although the one of the passage from the Apollo era to today represents a minor example, are called singularity, a term borrowed from physics and mathematics, where it is used to define a point of a function of which we are no longer able to describe the exact properties. To explain with some more or less fitting examples, we could imagine the singularity as that particular moment when a calculator suddenly signals us error division by zero, when dividing a constant by a smaller and smaller number up to infinity. Or more trivially, the singularity is that exact moment when a glass shatters when subjected to a sound that increases in frequency faster and faster. In physics, singularity is related to the phenomenology of black holes and the Big Bang itself, objects and events that it is possible to describe only passing from classical physics to quantum physics, and that anyway are considered a door that opens on a physical world totally unexplored. In the historical and social field, which is what interests us most at this moment, singularity is the technological change so rapid and so deep to cause a discontinuity in the normal path of human history. In 1983, writer and mathematician Werner Vinge popularized the theory in an article in which he argued that rapidly improving artificial intelligence would eventually reach a kind of singularity, beyond which reality would be difficult to predict. These are his words. "Soon we will create an intelligence greater than our own. When that happens, human history will have reached a kind of singularity, an intellectual transition as impenetrable as space-time nestled at the center of a black hole, and the world will be transformed beyond our comprehension." Something very similar had already been done by the English astronomer Gerald Hawkins, who in 1983 made public in his book Mind Steps to the Cosmos his notion of mind steps, dramatic and sudden changes of reality. Hawkins identified five main mind steps in the history of mankind and the technology we had led to these new worldviews: the invention of images, 30,000 BC, writing, 3000 BC, mathematics, 150 AD, the Copernican Revolution, 1543 AD, the Space Age, 1927. And as Hawkins himself points out, the waiting period between changes gets shorter and shorter, and even goes so far as to formulate an empirical mathematical equation capable of linking past steps and predicting future ones. The date of the next mind step, according to the English astronomer, is that of 2021, to which will follow in rapid acceleration that of 2045, 2051, and lastly that of 2053. It is a series of terms and steps that eventually stops because it reaches an insurmountable barrier. There is a mathematical limit, and no matter how many mental steps you keep adding, then you meet a time barrier that there is no way to cross. What happens from the mathematical point of view is that there comes a time when the mental steps are accelerated. The acceleration increases in such a way that after 2051, the successive mental steps occur every month, then every day, every hour, and every second, until in the year 2053, they pass by at an infinite speed. At that time, the human mind will have absorbed all the possible mental steps that can occur, and in a grand culmination, humanity will make the final adaptation to the greater cosmos. Destiny from the perspective of the equation, we will have arrived. Note that for Hawkins, the final mental step, the one that we could assimilate to the concept of singularity, will happen in 2053, a date very close to 2047 of Kurzweil. The nucleus of studies on the subject has been formed from the 90s onwards by people such as Ray Kurzweil, futurologist and author of books such as The Singularity is Near, in which the phenomenon is defined as the future point at which technological advances will begin to occur with such rapidity that normal human beings will not be able to keep pace and will be cut out of the cycle. Similarly to Hawkins, Kurzweil has proposed that humanity's scientific and technological journey can be divided into six different epochs. The first epoch is determined by a simple and general mass of information, energy, and matter. We aren't talking about millions of years ago when there were atomic structures that stored information of various kinds. After the Big Bang, millions of years later, atoms started to form, and then chemistry was born. From the meeting of atoms, molecules were born. It is necessary to mention carbon, that thanks to its atomic and molecular characteristics, is able to combine with other molecules, creating complex three-dimensional structures. Hang on a sec, guys, before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you will help us to make products of even higher quality. The second epoch is instead characterized by the development of organisms from carbon. DNA is the apex of the development of this epoch, allowing to transmit more and more information. The third epoch, following the mechanism of the previous epochs, starts from DNA to arrive at the development of complex organisms, equipped with sensory organs and ability to store information collected by the senses themselves. We have the development of brains and nervous systems. The fourth epoch differs from the others for the fact that biological progress has ended and has reached its peak with man. From now on, the development will mainly concern technology. From small and simple mechanical devices we have arrived today to sophisticated electronic equipment capable of managing and storing an impressive amount of data. Wanting to compare the biological development and the technical one, it is clear how the second has happened quickly and fast. About 2 billion years have passed from the origin of life to cells, only 14 years from the first laptop to the World Wide Web. The fifth epoch should be oriented indicatively from today to a near future, and within it, we would have the so-called fusion between human intellect and technology. It will happen, the definitive union man-machine, the technological singularity, as it has been often told in many movies and novels. This will allow us to expand both intellectual and technological horizons, thus overcoming the limits imposed by our biological system. Finally, the last epoch of the sixth described by Kurzweil foresees a future evolution that will allow, on the basis of singularity technologies, to overcome the limits of the universe as it is known today. We will be able to transform the entire universe into a complex, intelligent system. Just like Vinge, Kurzweil believes that we will arrive at the singularity by creating a superhuman artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence of that level could conceive of ideas that no human has thought of in the past and will invent technological tools that will be more sophisticated and advanced than anything we have today. Not all artificial intelligence scientists agree with the timeline Kurzweil provides. On the contrary, most experts believe that the evolutionary leap of artificial intelligence will happen later than 2029, around the mid-2040s. Others think that we need to wait until 2070. Although the predictions are different, they all agree on one fact. Designing truly intelligent computers is not only possible, but a matter of years or at most, decades. But is there anything to fear from such predictions? People such as Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Stephen Hawking, and other numerous scientists have raised serious alarms about the unknowns arising from a superintelligence, far superior to the human one. And they have voiced their concerns that artificial intelligence could escape our control and move against us. Musk and others who follow the growth of new technologies closely and speak knowledgeably propose setting ethical standards today before it becomes too late. They call on governments to act. In short, will the singularity be a wall we crash into or just a barrier we cross? When we asked whether or not this scenario will prove to be a threat to the world's population, Kurzweil instead replied that the idea of artificial intelligence capable of enslaving humans is pure invention. What is already happening is that machines are empowering us. They are making us smarter. In fact, according to the scholar, in the future we will be able to join the neocortexes of the brain, connecting the functions of learning, language, and memory. We will have a larger portion of the neocortex. We'll be more fun. We'll be better at playing musical instruments. We'll be sexier. We'll exemplify at all the laudable things in being human, but at a higher level. What is clear from the speech of the head of the engineering department of Google is that talking about singularity means talking about evolution. The human being of the future, in fact, could no longer be simply human but hybrid. The biological brain, fatigued by the immense amount of information that reaches us daily, would be enhanced through the support of nanorobotic implants. These implants, in addition to making learning and elaboration processes more efficient, would be able to connect our mind to the cloud of internet data, so that we would have access to almost unlimited knowledge. This is what Kurzweil thinks. But others, as we have already said, believe instead that machines will end up doing everything by themselves, thus excluding the human being from any hypothesis of hybridization. Machines able to read Shakespeare, make politics, tell a joke, argue. Machines that will learn by themselves and will transmit their knowledge to other machines, which in turn, in a short time, they will have reached and exceeded our global intellectual capacity. And a few months later, their powers will be incalculable. All this was anticipated in some way back in 1954 in a story by science fiction writer Frederick Brown, in which he imagines the construction of a galactic supercomputer. Having completed the work, the humans ask the computer as a first thing if there is a god, and the answer is fulminating. Now, yes.